pillow, beneath your knees, be nice and comfy. So check that you place your, the back of the knees on your pillow or your bolster, and then try to spread from there. Try to bring the hips, as always, a little bit forward so you can ground your lower back. Yeah. Then if you can do a little bit of effort just to lifting your head tiny from the floor to bring the chin toward the chest and then place it back. So you already have your spine nice and long, yeah? And open your arms. So as always, as we mentioned, when we do this first approach, don't worry if you are not super relaxed already, yeah? Oh. Just start to imagine that we give permission to yourself and to your body to start slowly to release and to relax, yeah? So depending how tense we are or how, you know, stress could take a while to connect, yeah? So have patience and just start to connect with the floor through the touch of your body on the mat and with your breath. Yeah, whatever is easier. Yeah, you can focus on the touching of your body on the mat on the floor, with your pillow. Yeah, every part of your body that is touching the floor, you can start to focus on that connection. Or you can focus on your breath, yeah? So maybe, Suzanne, for you, maybe focus on the grounding and the touching of the body instead of the breath, so you don't worry about, you know, maybe you are, it's more difficult to have a nice, comfortable breath, yeah? And just allow your body to start to settle. Bit by bit, imagine your body starting to open to this hour or so of relaxation. Start to imagine the planet offering a beautiful support and you expanding your roots or catching the roots that are already there. So you connect, you plug yourself there. And all around you, a beautiful cocoon as always of pink light. We can use also the violet or white light around you if we need to cleanse and to purify. Yeah, so Suzanne, you can use a white light here and imagine every time that you breathe in, you are receiving that white light that is purifying all your airways. And if you like, you can imagine a turquoise light, breathing a turquoise light and imagine that it's going to set in your neck and the top of your shoulders, your upper back, yeah? All that area is related with the turquoise, that is the throat chakra, yeah? So imagine that you are connecting with those lights. And every breath out, you are open to release, to let go of the tension, the stress, worries, anything that could be bothering. Now, as you keep relaxing, maybe you can cross your feet a little bit over each other, opening your knees softly on your pillow. It's just a soft crossing, eh? Nice and comfy. You keep relaxing your lower back on the floor and try to spread a little bit more your body. Just start to open hips. As you notice that you are relaxing, spread a little bit more your arms, spread your spine. And imagine that you are receiving energy from above, from beneath, from the planet. You can imagine opening the palms of your hands and imagine that you are receiving on the palms of your hands energy as well from above. And imagine that energy is entering into your arms and is going directly again to your shoulders, the back of your neck, your upper back, wherever you have your tension, yeah? So imagine when you breathe in, receiving that energy on the palms, moving up through your arms into your shoulders, your shoulder blades, your chest, your solar plexus. Imagine that it's an energy that is moving and cleansing and opening all the channels there. Ah, then slowly we will bend the legs, yeah? Taking your time. If you need, you move your bolster or your pillow from beneath so you can put your feet nice and grounding on the floor. Check again that your lower back, so bring the hips up again a little bit forward to ground your lower back, yeah? Lengthen again your spine, yeah? And we will bring the arms back and stretch your arms, but grounding the lower back on the floor. So do a little bit of effort to push your lower back on the floor and press like your shoulder blades toward the floor and try to stretch your arms behind, yeah? Along your head, bringing the chin toward the chest. Yeah, so you are doing, you're pressing your back against the floor, yeah? And then relax. We bring the arms above you. Yeah, nice and stretchy, but not tensing, yeah? And again, we will bring the arms behind again as you press with your lower back toward the floor. Check if you can put the arms behind you. If not, don't worry. And then again, bring your arms up above you, yeah? So breathe in. Press back. And breathe out and bring your arms above you. And one more time, back, back, back. Press your back. So you're pressing your back against the floor. And then one more time up. Yeah? And we do the last one. Back. Good. And then we will do the same, but in cross now. So we will open the arms in cross. If you don't have a space, you can bend your arms and move it like with your elbows. Yeah. And then again, up. Yeah. So breathe in. We round the arms and we bring the arms toward the floor. We try to catch the floor with your arms. And then up again. Round your arms. Go with the shoulder blades, your elbows, and then your hands. And then one more time. Round your arms, starting like with your upper arms toward the floor, your elbows. And then your wrist and your hands. And one more time up, and we do the last one. Well, very nice, and then relax, yeah? We will bring one knee toward your belly, relaxing your elbows, yeah? To soften your shoulder blades, chin toward the chest. Bring that leg towards you. Nice and soft. Soften. Yeah, imagine that you want to bring the leg like inside your body, but in a nice, relaxing way. Yeah? And then we open the knee. Keep relaxing your elbows. And then we stretch the leg up and we move the leg side to side. And then in circles. And then the opposite direction. And then the foot in circles. And flexing and stretching your foot, but keeping the knees always comfortable. And relax here, yeah. Place that leg back on the floor and we bring the other leg here, yeah. We catch the knee, release your elbows, bring the chin toward the chest, soften. And then we open the knee, relax. And then we bring the leg up. And we move the leg side to side. And then in circles. And the opposite direction. And then your foot in circles. And then bringing the leg back to the other leg, nice and open on the knee, and we bring the legs close and side to side. Keep your chin toward the chest. Relax. Relax, relax, relax. Yeah, side to side. Try to let your elbows soft falling so that allow the shoulder blades and shoulders to relax. And then we roll in circles. And then we change. And side to side. And then in circles. And then both legs. Side to side. Relax your shoulder blades. Yeah. Well done. And now we will keep the knees bending. We can catch the shins or your thighs or your feet, whatever you are right, without lifting the head from the floor. Yeah. And we will stretch one leg and keep one bending without tensing the leg. Yeah. So wherever is comfortable. Yeah. And then the other leg. Nice and comfy. Yeah? So babies do a lot of these movements here. These are really good to warm up the legs, but at the same time you are relaxing your back, you're stretching your spine, and you are moving the circulation on the legs that we really need it when you are many hours sitting or standing. Good. And then we will try to do with both at the same time, but nice and comfy, like a big happy baby pose. Yeah. Wherever is comfortable. So you catch your legs, your thighs, your shins, your feet. You want to feel also a nice big grounding on your shoulder blades, yeah, on your spine. There. So use the weight of your body and your legs to ground your back. Yeah. Keep the chin toward the chest. So we do one more. acuerdo. Now, we will do the last one here, yeah? We will keep one leg on the floor. Yeah? We will bring the thigh really close to your belly, yeah? Then we will stretch the leg up without tensing your knee, with the foot nice and flexed, yeah? And with the heel, we will go far away forward and down, but keeping the lower back toward the floor, yeah? Keep lengthening the back of the neck. So we go slowly, yeah? Bringing the heel far away. When you are right closer to the floor, you can pull with the heel and move maybe the leg a little bit side to side, really tiny there, to feel the stretching of your spine. So the chin is toward the floor. Your arms are expanding to feel the upper back, yeah? And then relax and bring the knee and the thigh toward your belly, yeah? So we do two or three, nice and soft, yeah? We want to feel a nice stretch. So ground your lower back. With your heel, you pull far away, far away. Maybe you move it a little bit side to side, closer to the floor or above, yeah? And then bring the knee and the thigh, yeah? We do it one more time. Heel, far away, far away. Stretch it. We want to feel like a nice expansion on your groin as well. And then relax, yeah? Put that leg back, and we do it exactly the same with the other leg. So, heel, comfy on the leg, yeah? Comfy on the knee. We go far away, far away. Spreading back. And bending. And again, push with your lower back against the floor. Yeah, we want to feel the lower back and the upper back nice and grounded, so you have a nice stretch on your hips. And then relax, yeah? This is for to release the position of being sitting maybe many hours, yeah? So when you go here far away, feel like the groin extending there, yeah? And then relax, well done, very nice. And we will roll toward one side. And we go to all fours. So, nice and open hands, fingers. And we roll in circles. Good, very nice. So we move the hips. Keep doing. Ah, hi, Anna. Welcome, welcome. Good. And then we go to the opposite direction. Try to bring the shoulders always rotated back away from your ears. And then on the center. Breathing, open arching, shoulders away. Breathe out and round. Breathing, open, expand. And round. And again. Then we curl the toes, we put the back of the toes on the floor, expanding open. And then squeeze. And again, breathing, expanding open. And squeeze. Bringing the belly a little bit in and squeezing above your pubic bone. One more time. And then we open the knees and we go to child pose, yeah? So we go back, 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 shoulders away, and we soft. Relax your elbows, relax your hips, soften back and down, surrender the weight of your body completely. So visualize the support of the planet. Imagine that you let go all your cares, falling into the planet and the planet take it for you, at least even for just this minute, yeah? Just let go, relax, surrender, and imagine always that cocoon around you so you feel secure and safe so you can relax even further. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And then come back to the center. We will keep the elbows on the floor. We'll bend the arms. We can put the hands like in prayer position or your hands behind your head or your shoulder blades. The elbows more or less closer if you can. And let your chest and your solar plexus relax toward the floor. You keep going back with your hips, yeah? And we soften as much as we can here. And then relax. And we go to all fours. And we will relax the shoulder blades, yeah? So we bring the arm beneath, shoulder, head. And we soften and we let go. Let go completely. And then relax, we go to the other side. And then coming back. And we go again to all fours. And we will stretch one leg back, shoulders away. And nice and soft, we round and we arch the back as we move the leg forward and back. Remember to move your head as well. Belly, when you bring the leg forward, is a little bit in. And working with your breath. Yeah, so when you go forward, breathe out. When you go back, breathe in and arch. And we do one more. And then stretch your leg back. Yeah. Flex your foot, your toes pointing toward the floor, and we try to lift in the lower back up, grounding your hands nice and strong, but without tensing your shoulders. Yes, yeah. So lifting the lower back up and try to keep the position for a little bit. And with your heel, you reach back. You can move a little bit side to side there, extending the back of your body. The crown of your head is going toward the front, yeah? So your crown of your head is extending and your heel is extending on the opposite direction.
And then relax, yeah? We go with the other leg. So breathing, expanding open and then round. Breathing open, expand and then round. Remember when you bring the leg forward, you bring your lower belly a little bit in as you move the knee forward. And that will work the core and the pelvic floor. Yeah, and take the tension from your lower back. One more time. And then we stretch the leg back, pull with your heel, toes pointing toward the floor, push with your hands without tensing your shoulders and lifting your lower back up. Lengthening, lengthening, heel far away and maybe moving side to side a tiny bit. So you feel that stretch, lengthen the back of the neck, yeah? And then relax, well done. We will sit in on the floor. We'll do a couple of stretches more before we go to the first restorative. Yeah? So crossing the legs or open, wherever feels comfortable. Ground your hips, catch your knees, and lifting solar plexus and chest, and check that your shoulders are down, back and down. Yeah. So breathing open, breathe out, relax. And back, yeah? So you go behind your hip and then you go again into your hips and open, elbows down, yeah? Go. So do a few in your own time, connecting with your breath. Go. One more time. And last one. Good. And then we will roll with your upper body, like around your hips. Good. And try to ground your hips and feel how your inner thighs are working there as you move. Try to relax your shoulders, relax your hands. Breathing forward, breathe out back. Breathing forward, breathe out. This movement you can do even sitting on the chair if whenever you need to release a little bit and relax, yeah? Or calm down, we go to the opposite direction. This mimic the movement of the mom rocking a baby. Yeah? So it's a really soothing and calming sensation for the body and for the mind, yeah? One more time. And then on the center, pushing again with your hips, lifting solar plexus and chest, relax your shoulders, lifting your arms without tensing your shoulders. And we stretch, keeping your hips nice and grounded. Yeah? So you reach up with your hand, but the hip is like a reaching down to the center of the planet. Yeah. So you really stretch the side of your body. One more time. And then we will reach with the hands with both. Flex your hands and with the palms reaching up, but without lifting the shoulders, yeah? So you keep pushing with your hips into the floor and with the palms, you can look up to the ceiling and then relax. Soft, yeah? We put the hands behind you, again with the shoulders relaxed, and we open the chest. Spreading. Yeah, the head a little bit back, but not that much that is painful or uncomfortable on your neck. Then relax. Yeah, keeping that nice opening, we will rotate toward one side. Breathing deeply, open chest, belly a little bit in to support the lower back as you rotate. We try to look behind us. Without tensing your neck.
Bring the belly a little bit in to support the spine as you rotate. And then relax, coming back to the center, pushing again to the floor, and we go to the other side, lifting solar plexus and chest, shoulders away from your ears, belly in. And then relax, well done. Now put the hands over your shoulders, we finish here. And move the elbows a little bit here, soft, yeah? So check, for me it's more comfortable going back, but maybe for you, forward. So we will do both, yeah? So we go back, soft, soft, soft. We want to move the area just to release the tension, yeah? And then the opposite, forward. Yeah. So you move like it with your elbows. You try to keep the shoulders down, yeah? Even if you feel stiff, slowly with the elbows, lead with this part, let's say, the movement, yeah? So back. This is a nice movement that you can do while you are sitting in the computer, yeah? And then forward, just to release. I don't know if you notice when you move, you are working from the beginning of your shoulder blades. Yeah, so that this releases all the tension that we keep. Yeah, soften. Yeah, relax. Well done, ladies. So we will go to the first restorative. We will start with child pose, and we have it a little bit abandoned. Yeah, so Suzanne, maybe if you feel that it's too low for your breathing, keep the bolster in a diagonal position, okay? So we put the bolster flat or with a block or a pillow here. If you need, you put your blankets. I know it's nice and warm, but always something above you is like giving you the sensation of that cocoon, yeah? Even just above your lower back. So we open the knees, nice and comfy. So to go into the bolster, open again. Yeah, don't go rounding already. Open, 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 yeah? You start like going between the belly, between the legs, and then the rest of your body on the bolster, yeah? And then your head, yeah? So you check if you need the bolster flat or with the cushion above you or beneath your head. And remember, if at any point the knees are bothering you, you can always extend the legs back to make it more comfortable. Now, once you are there, try to spread your spine, relax your elbows on the floor, and try to surrender slowly into the bolster. And now, again, imagine that cocoon around you. You are like safe in it, really safe, like a heaven of sacred place, yeah? And all that energy above, the pink light, the white, and the violet, and maybe the turquoise as well to release your upper back. Imagine all those energies working from above, passing through your body, and through your whole self, allowing you to release, yeah, all the emotional and physical tension and stress. And imagine the bolster catch it for you and put it on the floor on the planet. And the planet take it for you. And you can imagine that same stress or tension that is being recycle on the planet, so you can absorb back your own energy now, free and fresh, recharge, plus the nourishing energy of the planet, like extra nourishing energy to recharge you even further. And just allow yourself to be trespassed by these beautiful energies.
And each breath out, you surrender more and more. And each breath in, you are receiving. If you notice tension on your shoulders, just focus on your elbows. Yeah? Let your elbows ground toward the floor. And slowly your chest will adapt to the shape of the pillow and the bolster, allowing your upper back to relax too. Again, maybe you keep the tension, but you always will release some, and that even that little release will help you. Yeah? So trust and surrender. You can focus also on your heart center, being grounded now and opening to the bolster. And imagine that you receive a beautiful cleansing of the heart and a beautiful loving energy to fill it up completely. Really slowly, without moving so much, we will bring the head to the other side and we put the other cheek on the bolster or the pillow. And we keep relaxing and surrender. And then slowly, really slowly, bring the head to the center and gently we lift in the chest from the floor, from the bolster. Yeah? And we'll stay for a moment there. Relaxing your arms, letting the elbows fall. Just take a nice couple of nice deep breaths here. Now we will turn around. Yeah? If you have the bolster flat, put something high here. Yeah, and we will turn around to the back. Yeah. Now, if you have, you can have another two pillows or blocks to help you with the legs. Yeah. So we turn around. We put the hips nice and close to the bolster or the pillows. Yeah. The legs could be crossing or extending, but if you can crossing, or even you can put the feet together, the sole of your feet, and with extra cushions, you place it beneath your thighs to support. Yeah. Okay. So confident, put again your blanket. So you like you feel that your heart is covered. Yeah? Just to feel like a more secure, a sensation of more being supported and protected. Yeah. So when you go back, try to spread your spine. Now again, bring the chin a little bit toward the chest. So you really extend the back of the neck and you place it nice and long on the bolster. Yeah. Then take your time. Remember the hands on the shoulders, like we did that circle when we were sitting. Put your hands first on your shoulders or on your chest and allow your shoulder blades there to spread. Yeah. Open your elbows. Yeah. Allow your shoulder blades to feel like a mimic the shape of the bolster, and then spread your arms to the floor. So we want a nice open position, but comfortable at the same time. Yeah. So move a little until you really find your comfortable position. If at any point you feel that you need, you can place your hands on your solar plexus, your belly, on your heart. Yes, sometimes you feel the need to do it, so do it. Yeah. And just surrender. So again, imagine the planet completely have you, like a really supported, and all around you, you have the beautiful cocoon with the loving energy, the pink light, the white light to purify your energy field, your body, your mind, your heart, and then the violet to give you more connection and more cleansing and transformation or transmutation again of your energy field. And just allowing this gesture of being nice and open and receptive. Again, to receive all the nourishing energy that is available for you right now. Imagine with every breath, you are receiving everything that you need. It is easy, in this easy way. Yeah, imagine that just the breath is enough or have all the power to bring you everything that you need. As you relax and as you open. In your time, you will move a little bit your hands and your fingers, and bring your hands above your heart or your solar plexus or your belly, and have your hands for a moment there. Imagine that you are
Like a close in here, just to keep all that nourishing inside you. Or like a gesture of checking that you have everything there, you know, that you got is there inside. And you won't lose it when you move from this position. It's just a gesture of anchoring the feeling and the sensation. And then slowly we can stretch your arms back and extend your legs. And then we will roll really gently toward one side, bending your knees. And we make like a little ball on the side, bending your knees. And then slowly coming back. Oh. And now we will take the bolster out. Yeah. We will lie down on the back and we will have the bolster or a pillow or a block to put beneath your bum. Yeah. Okay. So we will lie down with that pillow there, bending your knees. So ground your lower back. Again, bring the chin towards the chest. And move a little bit with your back to really ground your back on the floor. And we will place the block or the pillow beneath your hips here. Yeah? Coffee. Yeah, so again, bring the chin toward the chest, lengthen the back of the neck, open your arms. And we will start first before we relax completely. We will extend slowly. So with your feet, you walk forward. Yeah. And extend the legs softly. You keep the belly a little bit in. Yeah. Just to again stretch your groins, the front, without forcing it. So wherever is more or less comfortable, could be not comfortable at all. Yeah, just go there wherever is okay. Extend. Check if it's okay to stay a little bit. If you manage to extend the legs completely, you can even bring the toes pointing out, so flexing your feet, and with your heels again, do that movement of pulling out with your heels, yeah, far away from you, like we did at the beginning. As you ground your shoulder blades on the floor and the chin toward the chest. Just a little bit, yeah? It's not relaxing, this pose, unless you feel really comfortable, yeah? That is a nice stretch. And then slowly you walk back with your feet. And as you walk back, reaccommodate your back because maybe now you can spread more. Yeah. Good. So we will work a little bit with the legs here to allow a nice releasing on the lower back and the legs, yeah? So we will lift in the legs slowly up with your knees, yeah? And then slowly the legs up. The legs nice and bendy, comfy, yeah? Like a happy baby pose position. Could be closed or could be open, whatever you find more comfortable. And let your lower back go like toward the floor. Yeah, you are falling like into a roundy back there, the feeling, but you are stretching your spine. Bring the chin again toward the chest. And keep your arms relaxing. Yeah? Soften. So the weight of your body is helping, the weight of your legs is helping your back to expand more and spread more. And imagine the planet receiving your weight, receiving you with open arms. And then bend the legs. You can cross your feet here. You can keep the arms on the floor, or maybe you have the need to put the hands on your knees or your thighs. Yeah? So let your body decide what you prefer here. And then slowly we put one leg toward the floor. And we put the other leg slowly. And we stay in that position, relaxing, yeah. Letting your hips relax on the block, letting your lower back relax toward the floor. Surrendering, yeah, letting your back surrender to the floor. And then slowly, really gently, we take the block from your hips and bring your lower back toward the floor. Keep the knees bent, yeah? So keep the feet on the floor and just let your back relax there for a moment. Remember, when we do this kind of work, we can always feel or a hot sensation or a cold sensation on your lower back. That's okay, yeah? And soft, deeply. Stay for a moment there. Bring your chin toward the chest. And then from here, we will go gentle to, really gentle to spinal twist. Yeah? So we'll bring the knees toward one side. Yeah, you can move your hips a little bit out first and nice and comfy, relaxing there. Let go. And remind yourself of that cocoon around you with the loving energy in pink, the white light to purify, the violet light for connection and deep cleansing and transformation. Keep imagining, like we did before, your palms open to receive the energies as well. Yeah, so imagine an entrance on your hands for the energy that is moving toward your arms and your upper back, your chest, your lungs, yeah, all the internal organs, all of your physical body, plus the emotional and spiritual energy that we receive.
And then slowly we move to the other side, taking your time. And we soften. And then coming back to the center. And we go to Shavasana. Nice and comfy, nice and flat. If you need, you put your pillow beneath your knees. If you feel lower back pain, if not, just flat. Yeah, put your blankets. And I will lead you to a nice, comfy relaxation. We will use, as always, our my stones here. So find your nice, comfortable place. Visualize again the planets, the planet, the roots, supporting you, minding you, sending you all the nourishing energy that you need, plus the cocoon around you with protection and energy. And then imagine that you will receive this extra energy. Imagine that all the powers of the energy that we combine, plus you know, the chakra stones here, you will receive everything that you need. Yeah? So imagine this energy arriving right now to your house. Yeah, imagine that it's covering your house as well. And opening the sole of your feet to receive this extra energy, to relax you, to bring more comfort and relief and peace. So imagine this energy moving into your heels, through the sole of your feet, into your toes, the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your thighs and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, your spine, your shoulder blades, your shoulders, your arms, your hands, your fingers. And then imagine that energy moving into your wrists, elbows, your shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly, allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now. Relax. Relax, relax. out slowly. Really slowly. Allow your awareness to head back to your body. And start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet. Moving your fingers, your toes. Moving your head side to side. And bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. And from there we fall to one side, bending your knees. And we go to a sitting position. And you can bring your hands to your heart or to your belly. And give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to join this class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me.